C4 and Bryan Nehman.
WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
Well, right now, when it comes to crime, they want people to be held accountable. They want violent repeat offenders to be in prison. They want individuals carrying illegal guns to go to jail. And they want quality of life crimes prosecuted in a way that they're held accountable. They're not looking for those individuals to go to jail, but they're tired of them being on the street, loitering, trespass, where they can't even go to walk to church because everybody's loitering and trespass. They want those individuals to do community service.
That is Ivan Bates, city state's attorney, on our show yesterday, talking about what the citizens of Baltimore want.
That's what they're telling him.
Says he's been around knocking on doors, obviously, during the campaign, and he hears exactly what the citizens are looking for. And part of the deal is that he wants to increase the maximum sentence on individuals from 3 to 5 years if you are caught with a gun. That's for 21 and older.
Right.
It was met with some resistance.
Initially.
That resistance has thawed. I think that's fair
that's
to say.
Good,
we are pleased to be joined now by Cory McCray, state senator. Great to have you on the
good
show.
Morning,
always
Senator.
Appreciate your time.
Hey, Brian, AC4, how are you all doing today?
We're doing well. So you have decided to get on board with this proposal or with this desire from Ivan Bates for a modification to the law. Why are you on board with it now, and were you ever against it? I want to also throw in.
Just like anything, you want to take a look and hear what is going on, Brian, to be honest with you. Ivan Bates is our number one top prosecutor, our city state's attorney. He came to Annapolis with one thing that he wanted to accomplish this legislative session. As soon as I was able to see the language, C4 was a legislator. We saw the language because the bill was dropped, I want to say Friday, immediately Sunday. We saw what it was. It was common sense. It was a loophole that exists. For those folks that are 18 to 20, there's a 5-year sentence. For those folks that are 21 and older, there's a 3-year sentence. He's looking to course correct with that direction. If this is one of the tools that he needs in the toolbox, we stand as one team, Team Baltimore, and our city state's attorney is part of that team. And as the 45th Legislative District leadership team, myself, Jackie Addison, and Kaylin Young, we thought that it was common sense to move in a direction with our city state's attorney.
We're speaking of Baltimore City State Senator Cory McCray, who represents the 45th District in East Baltimore. And Senator McCray, when it comes to the overall philosophy that you heard from the state's attorney, it is different than the prior state's attorney when it comes to Marilyn Mosby. He doesn't want to lock people up for low-level crimes, as he told us, but he does want to improve the quality of life for that grandmother trying to go to church. And the reason I bring that up is because there seems to have been this resistance in Annapolis from particularly the city delegation to moving in a direction like this. Can you talk about whether there's conflict with what the state's attorney is saying or whether or not you all can see where you can meet on this?
Well, first, we've already met. I just want to be clear, C4, but at the end of the day, his message is clear and concise. That he would like to close the loophole is common sense. If it already exists for a certain age group, why doesn't it exist for the same age group? Immediately after seeing it, what you do is you take a position on it. And we wanted to openly, publicly take a position. Our city state's attorney is less than 30 days on the job. I just want to signal to our constituents, to our neighbors, to our friends and family members within our respective district that we're moving in the same direction and they're working in unison with our city state's attorney as the 45th. District leadership team.
Well, Senator, before I leave this topic with you, though, when it comes to his philosophy, though, of, you know, not ignoring, as we've seen, whether it's open container in the Fells Point or other areas or other things, that kind of being ignored. He said, I'm not going to ignore that. He said, I want to improve the quality of life. Is that a problem, just hearing that from you and the other legislators in Annapolis? Because before it seemed like that was a problem.
Well, I think that you could talk about what you're going to do. I think that you lead by action. And I think that signaling right now, taking a public open position in reference to what our city state's attorney is trying to accomplish and moving in a direction sends a clear signal to our constituents that we're moving in the same direction as our city state's attorney.
Well, then, Ken, I don't know if you heard the soundbite that I played coming out of what he says citizens want in Baltimore City. Do you agree with that? Is that what you're hearing from your constituents?
So let me be clear. I've also served a term in the House of Delegates. I was reelected in the Maryland State Senate, and I knock doors all the time, Brian, all the time. This isn't something new. Public safety is on the mind of my constituents. It's the number one thing on the mind of constituents moving forward, and I would say the education falls second.
So, Senator Cory McCray, when it comes to the governor, we had Governor Wes Moore on yesterday as well, and he talked about he would sign this bill if it made it to his desk and that type of thing. It's got to be, you know, it doesn't have to be, but it's introduced by a member of the House of Delegates now, Delegate Frank Conway. Have you heard about any city senator so far that's willing to introduce this yet, or is this still in the process?
This is still in the process. I also had a conversation with our city state's attorney just in reference to the process. Keep in mind that he's also new. And I explained to him that any time that an agency, and he is an agency, he has an agency that they can always put in a request by the request of. So I think that these are nuances that we're working out. He's less than 30 days on the job, but just being clear and concise that we want to move in unison in the same direction. And there are tools and processes in order to do that. There's no way that one of our city state's attorney, our mayor, our sheriff can come to anyone and say that they didn't have anyone to put in a bill, because as you know, C4, the governor, all of these different agencies can always do a by request of via the Baltimore City chairman.
But I also know, though, you're right, but I also know that it helps if you know, you get that type of support from the chair, who, by the way, now is State Senator Jill Carter, who is opposed to this publicly. That's the only reason I bring that up.
Even if they're opposed, they still have the responsibility to carry the duty of that respective agency within that respective jurisdiction.
Okay.
So was the holdup that it just wasn't following proper protocol of why there was resistance to this very mild, you know, request from the city state's attorney on the change of a law or a clarification, if you will, even maybe?
Brian, resistance is your word. So, like, keep in mind, like, any bill, there are over 2,000 bills. One of the things that I like to do is actually see what the language is. There have been a number of occasions where people say that a bill does this and the intent or things of that nature may be clear, but the bill does something different. And there are a number of phone calls. If you sign on to something and you're not clear, it can articulate what that bill is trying to do. Upon seeing that language, on Friday, immediately Sunday, put out a press release that we are publicly supporting and moving in the same direction as our city state's attorney.
Senator Cory McCray.
There's no resistance in that equation.
Senator Cory McCray, I saw you at a groundbreaking yesterday for a new elementary school in your legislative district, so congratulations on that. Everybody needs to understand it's very, very rare to get new schools and groundbreakings that are occurring. But let me ask you, because I know you've been an advocate for pushing for CTE education. My day it was vocational education. We just had the announcement from President Biden yesterday about 20 to 30,000 new jobs coming, construction jobs, to our area. But many of our kids aren't prepared for this, Senator McCray. As we're pushing Kerwin, can we get an emphasis in Annapolis this session to make sure we improve our CTE, you know, programs to help our kids get ready for this?
Very much so, C4. So just lifting up the piece that you're talking about and making sure that the listeners are moving in the same direction. Furley Elementary was a school that was closed, and it was a hard fight, arduous fight. Since 2016, I reflected on my first letter that I sent that said that it was wrong that this school was not moving in the same direction and being newly built, and being able to see that come to fruition was one of the greatest opportunities and one of my long-term goals on my list. But when you move in the direction of CTE, it's important for the listeners to understand that I'm the only legislator out of 188 that went through a five-year apprenticeship program with the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, and I feel like that shifted the trajectory of my life. So when you have our young men, young women growing up in urban jurisdictions that's not exposed to a lot, this is one of the few opportunities that do exist in apprenticeships. So each and every day, I try my best, and I said, I can talk about it, but lead through action. What we've done to try to remediate some of these situations is not only push on North Avenue, but also step up ourselves. We've done a bus tour every year with all of the high schools within our district, just like they do college tours. Mm-hmm. Why aren't we doing apprenticeship tours? And we've done that for the last 4 years. C4 partner with College Bell and a number of the building trades within the respective industry. We also have to make sure that they're getting close to this and exposed to this at a younger age. So we saw some of the ARPA dollars that Dr. Santa Lisa used with our middle school students. And at Mergenthaler, you saw classes during the summer to talk about different professions and making sure that they are exposed to that, those opportunities, understand those opportunities, and kind of get them the creative juices to go to see and say that I can do these types of things. But the more that we take them in these spaces that me, you, and Bryan know about, the more our young people will be successful and successful through the CTE process.
I don't know if this the building or the construction is going to be in your jurisdiction. I'm just curious to get your thoughts because they said there's going to be tens of thousands of jobs that are going to be created by this in that field. Is it going to be difficult to find people to work on it? Because obviously it's been tough to find a lot of people in a lot of different working environments. And do you know how disruptive it may be in the area where they're going to be working on this project?
So infrastructure is huge. So when you think about not just rail, as they talked about the BMT, the Frederick Douglass Tunnel, you got to think about our roads, our bridges, this broadband infrastructure that they're talking about, our water mains. Infrastructure has a large, large definition. But I do think that pipeline we have to be ready for because it's coming in a significant amount of federal, state, and local dollars that's being injected into our economy. And we can benefit from them. And shame on us if we do not prepare for it.
State Senator Cory McCray, what are some of the things you're looking to accomplish this legislative session as we have a new governor now and a whole new kind of atmosphere in Annapolis?
Well, I started off with supporting our city state's attorney, working with the mayor on a home monitoring bill to make sure that they're coordinated between Department of Public Safety and our police department. Also making sure that those long-term and short-term goals that are put forward continue to move. We talked about Fairleigh Elementary, but Northeast Elementary is next. We have a food insecurity within our respective district and working with the folks down there with Henson Development to make sure that we can bring a supermarket to East Baltimore. I think that would be monumental. During my tenure, two have closed, so I would like to at least see one open up. This is not easy, Seafood, but I do believe that we're going to make it happen, and I'll make sure that I reach out when it does happen. But
please
like, bringing
do.
A grocer to East Baltimore is one of the main things in on my agenda while also working with our educational outcomes because I have four young people at home and thinking about how do all the young people in the city of Baltimore and the state of Maryland impacted by these Kerwin dollars that's going to be injected into our system.
And people need to know you are a very active dad going to all types of events. I see you all over the place, Senator McCray, going to all your kids,
yes, sir.
All your kids' events.
Can I just revisit the gun thing for just 1 second? And that is, you know, I think the frustration that a lot of us have, that I have certainly, is that it doesn't seem like anything that comes out of Annapolis really makes it difficult on the criminal. And it just in recent weeks and recent months, you know, we've had a blame being put on the gun industry by the mayor, by Popeyes. You know, Jill Carter was talking about the little guy who winds up with a gun in her testimony. Antonio Hayes said that the juvenile crime is actually going down. We had state officials testifying that they've seen declines in the detention population. It's because, well, we can't arrest 12-year-olds anymore at that level. And then the very first bill that comes out of the Senate, SB1, goes after law-abiding citizens who just want to have the ability to carry a gun to protect themselves. So that's where, you know, the frustration comes from, where it's like you're doing everything or you're telling these things that other people are responsible for, that it doesn't make any sense. And yet the criminal, you know, we can't even just get a amen when the prosecutor says, can we just make it 5 years instead of 3 years?
So let me be clear, Bryan, we are a body of 188 individuals. I'm going to repeat that for the listeners, 188 individuals. So when we talk about public safety, I've always had public safety at the top of the list. I'm going to start with redistricting, police audits, police officers living in the city. We are, and I'm not a foreigner to the show. Warrant, so Governor Hogan, we partnered to make sure that we can decrease the number of open warrants that we have on out, not just in the city of Baltimore, where it was prevalent, but across the state of Maryland. That was an extra $2.5 million dumped in the previous fiscal cycle, but also the one that we're in at this moment to make sure that we can close the open warrants that are there. And the reports have come out to say that it's been sound fiscal policy, that direction that we moved in. So I hear you loud and clear, but keep in mind that we're a body of 188. I've always come on your show, and I think that me and you, or me, it's definitely me and C4, have been moving in the same direction about how do we resolve the issues within the city of Baltimore and the state of Maryland.
State Senator Cory McCray, always great to speak with you. We'll talk with you throughout the legislative session, and good to see your letter with your two delegates. And I did notice the third delegate isn't on that letter, Delegate Smith.
Well, people still have to make their minds up. And,
okay.
And you know, you pull the ones that you can, and
you
let the other ones make their minds up.
Just wanted to ask. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Senator. Appreciate it.
Thanks for coming on.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much.